My name is Jeff Winter, and I am a manufacturing industry executive. Today, we're excited to speak with Jake Hall, also known as the Manufacturing Millennial. Now, if you don't know Jake, he is one of the top industry thought leaders and influencers in the manufacturing industry. He's an avid speaker at manufacturing trade shows and conferences, and is famously known for his informative, yet sometimes comical posts about the manufacturing industry and Industry 4.0 on social media. And today we're going to be talking about how technology is changing the world of manufacturing and allowing us to build agile factories. And with that, let's welcome Jake.
Awesome. Hey, Jeff, thanks for that awesome intro. It's good to be here.
Well, I'm glad you could be here. So, Jake, we hear lots of buzzwords in this space: smart manufacturing, connected factory, smart factory, agile factory. And as someone who lives and breathes manufacturing, why do you like the term agile factory, and what does it mean to you, and how does it differ than traditional manufacturing?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. I think I really like the idea of an agile factory because it represents the current state of so many manufacturers right now, where everyone is going through change. Everyone is going through a demand of market conditions that like didn't exist 6 months ago or 2 years ago. I think of traditional manufacturing where like I think of it as a very rigid process, right? They're so focused on driving as much efficiency out of a single line and a single process as possible. That's just the way manufacturers did it for so long. But what we're seeing now in manufacturing as just the demand for domestic manufacturing increases, the demand for new products increases, the demand for technology being integrated into products changes. You know, this idea of agileness is required. And, you know, flexibility is another thing, that or adaptability is a thing that comes to mind right away. So when you look at what's the importance of manufacturers moving to in an agile type process, it's how do we make it so customers can come to market quicker with a solution or with a product or a process in which they're solving, you know, a problem that's either coming from their customer or even internally, like within the factory.
I like that way of describing it. So we all know that technology plays a pretty massive role in making all this come together, but how do you see it being used, and what technologies are you seeing deployed the most often in building an agile factory?
Yeah. I mean, so data and analytics, right? This acquiring of data is huge. But some other things like I think that we're missing on is like AR, VR, for example. As a millennial, this guy who just loves new technology, this idea of how do we better leverage technology to make our processes simplified or make it so we're reducing the amount of training that's happened within a workforce. Like a VR headset I can put on and it will tell me the exact work instructions that need me, that require my machine to have a changeover when I'm running a new part, right? You know, we're a plastic injection company and we're running this tool, and now we got to have this new tool that a customer now allows us to make 10,000 parts over. Well, if I put on a HoloLens or like a Google Glass or something, and this technology is walking me through these steps and these processes automatically, you know, that allows us to have better flexibility within our manufacturing process. Like AR, VR is one. And like the other one I think of right away is robotics. For so long, robotics was such a discrete process, I would almost call, right? Where we're going in there, we're teaching a robot to do these 30 position moves over and over again, which includes picking up parts, inserting the parts within a clip, inspecting the part, and then going out there, backing away, and doing the same cycle over again. But like with an agile factory, all of a sudden robots can do so much more when they leverage technology, because they can almost think for themselves in a sense where now I can leverage AI, and that AI can say, well, hey, I need to pick this part, but that part's not always in the exact same position. But now, because I'm leveraging this new technology, the robot doesn't need to have an operator teach it a new path or a new program each time. The robot can be flexible where now I can pick that part that is coming out of a tote that before a single operator was just loading all the time. Well, now a robot can use a bin picking system with AI to do that for me. You know, and I think that's where just we see once again, technology creates flexibility, which creates agileness in manufacturing, which just allows manufacturers to be able to do essentially what I would say more like with less.
Knowing that transformative initiatives leveraging technology can completely change the type of jobs that exist and even the type of work that people do, what impacts are you seeing on the workforce?
Yeah. So right now in the US, there's like 750,000 open jobs in manufacturing. By like 2028, 2030, we're going to have like 2.4 million. So like this crazy amount of unfulfilled jobs in manufacturing, a lot of those what we would classify as skilled jobs. And I think the one thing that what manufacturers are going to face is when we leverage new technology, when we put new technology, new equipment, new machines on the factory floor, people need to be trained. People need to learn how to operate this type of new equipment. And so while an agile factory, a smart factory, a new factory has a lot of benefits, it also has a lot of negatives because your current workforce might not have the skill sets required to run the new equipment. So it creates a demand for us to continue to reskill our workers. And I think it's one of those things where technology these days has reduced so much in terms of an entry point or a barrier to implementation, where it's become a lot easier now, right? We want to program a robot. Before, you had to be an electrical engineer to pick up a teach pendant to program a robot. Well, now you can program a robot just simply by dragging it around with an iPad, you know? And so we need to reskill workers to leverage new technology, but at the same time, we need to continue to cross-train. And I think it's just coming out of a pandemic, we've all saw that, where we don't have the same amount of workforce that we did leading in 2019 and up to 2020. And we need to leverage, once again, flexibility, but not only flexibility in our products, but flexibility in our people. And if we can work with our employees by leveraging technology to make our employees more productive, that's going to help us with our future workforce and, you know, help us with job training and job roles. And at the end of the day, I think as well, it helps with employee satisfaction. And like, I think we could have like a 45-minute podcast just on how do we create employee satisfaction within manufacturing. But I think when employees can work better and do more critical thinking themselves, they feel like they have a lot more purpose in what they do versus a non-agile traditional manufacturing facility where they did the same job over and over again for 8 hours a day, picking that part out of a bin, loading it into a cell for that robot to do. Now we can have that person be a technician or a mechatronics person who can manage that cell and problem solve a lot more technical stuff. So they feel that they're contributing more to the manufacturer's overall, I guess you could say, productivity or their impact and their purpose for what general manufacturing can be.
Yeah, and I absolutely run into that every day. So I see it too. So when you talk to manufacturers, what advice do you give them if they want to start to build this agile factory? And what do they need to consider before making the transition?
Yeah. The first one I would say is employee engagement, right? You know, you need to have your workforce, your people, you know, ready to go and signed up to support you on your journey. And so if you're not engaging with your employees to say, we want to reskill you, we want to train you to adapt to this new technology, that's where you need to start. I think the other thing to do is look at what technology is best suited for you. And a lot of times there's so many different companies out there that are each plugging their own software solution, they're each plugging their own robot, or how they're leveraging AI or machine learning to you know, create the best solution for them. I think what manufacturers need to look at is, how do I take a bite of the apple and see how that bite can best fit into the low-hanging fruit within my factory? And I think, you know, as well with that, it's how do you better leverage skill development is the other big thing that I would push from that is your people are so critical to your manufacturing process. And I think we are so focused on the products that we produce that a lot of times we forget about the people that are actually solving the problems. So the one thing that I would say is when you're building an agile factory, before you push on that transition, you need to make sure that your workforce is skilled and ready to begin to adapt to that technology. But more importantly, that your workforce is ready to actually make decisions and actionable, you know, motion to make that happen, right? We can have the smartest factory in the world that gives us every single data down to when, you know, an extra electron was pulled on a machine running production. But if we can't make actionable decisions on that, there's no value driven from that. So having the correct skill force and the correct people in place to then make decisions to push agile manufacturing forward is huge. You know, the last thing I would add to that as well is, how can manufacturers better collaborate with their partners? A lot of times I feel like manufacturers feel they just need to do everything on their own and they need to do it by themselves. But when there's so many other partners out there through companies or suppliers or individuals, or even a lot of times local state like programs are in place to help companies increase smart manufacturing, leverage those and get that experience, and don't try and create an agile factory on your own. Work on it and work with other people, and you're going to have a lot more success that way.
Well, I think that's great advice. And yes, I'm familiar with a lot of those local agencies and programs that are available as well. So thank you, Jake, for sharing your perspective and insights with us today. And if you're interested in hearing more about top trends in manufacturing, watch the rest of our series and hear other industry experts discussing the latest trends they're seeing in the intersection of technology and manufacturing.